achievement that you all have acquired. We, as citizens of the United States and of the Commonwealth of Virginia, are engaged in a great experiment in democracy. That experiment in democracy is an experiment that involves self-governance. That self-governance is seen in many ways, most obviously and publicly, in occasions such as this, where elected representatives take an oath to be loyal to the Constitution of the United States and to the Constitution of the Commonwealth of Virginia. The great experiment in democracy that we are engaged in is tested every day. And we should not lose sight of that. We should not lose sight of the fact that individuals who are elected or appointed to serve in positions of responsibility owe a deep duty, not only to the citizens themselves, but to the Constitution. It is a living and meaningful document. Very often in this day and age, the Constitution, both it and the Constitution of the Commonwealth, are given lip service. People bandy those words around without taking to heart what they really mean. And at the root of what they mean is that we have an incredible responsibility, and we also have incredible privileges that run with that responsibility. The United States is rare, if not unique, among the nations of the world because of that democracy and that self-governance. And we have been doing this now for well over 200 years. So there is a legacy for each of you to follow and to live up to ensure that the next generation will have the blessings of liberty that we all have as well. And that means that each of us, myself included, have a responsibility to perform our tasks in accordance with the oath that each of you have taken to the best of your ability. So I urge you to take those words to heart and to perform your tasks in this community with devotion to your neighbors, to your families, and to the Constitution. So thank you again for coming, and I wish you the very best.